Hi. I have no idea where to start. I've been sitting here staring at the screen for the past 10 minutes, wondering where to start. It's just so complicated. The whole story is so complicated. So basically, long story short, for the past 3 winters, including this winter, I've basically experienced symptoms of Tourette syndrome. I have never been diagnosed with Tourette syndrome. I don't remember having any tics as a child. I have quite a fair amount of OCD behavior as a child that I feel like I mostly grew out but never any tics that I I can think of. So let's see how to make this as short as I possibly can. 8 years ago, when I was 20, I got a flu shot, and that evening I was visiting my boyfriend, now my husband, at his parents' house, and it just started shaking, just like uncontrollably, and I could feel it like building up. How I've always described it is, it feels like when you have a stomach bug. And like you can feel that sensation building up in your stomach, and it just keeps getting worse and worse. And you know that eventually you're going to throw up, and you might be able to do some things to kind of delay that from happening. Like maybe if you go outside and get some fresh air, or you lay down on the cold bathroom floor, you can keep it from happening for a few more minutes. But eventually, you're gonna puke. So that's kind of what it feels like to me. So I just started shaking, and it was all like in my neck and shoulders. And I couldn't stop, and I shook for several hours that night. Ended up staying in the guest room that night because I did not trust myself to be able to drive home. So then the next night, well, the next day, I thought, you know, it was just a weird fluke reaction. And everything will be fine now. The next night it started happening again. So my mom took me to the ER, which was actually ridiculously funny because the nurse the nurse asked, "So why are you here?" And I just started laughing. I was like, is it like not obvious?" I'm sure she thought I was on drugs. So they dumped, I don't know, Xanax or something in me. Pretty much knocked me out. And for the next several months, I did all kinds of testing, 3-day EEG, MRI, tilt table. I honestly don't remember what all I did, because they had me on Ativan at the time, and I felt like a zombie for months, and it was terrible. It did help with the shaking, but it was really awful and not my favorite thing ever. So I don't remember, but it was lots and lots and lots of tests. And they never diagnosed me with anything. So eventually, this all started at the end of October, 2008. So around February or March, they just started going away on their own. So I started weaning off the medications I was on and was mostly fine after that. I would have what I would call an episode, maybe once a month for the first year after that. And then it was down to like every couple of months, and then it was down to just like a couple times a year. Like once or twice a year, it would come up one night, and the next day I would be really groggy and feeling lousy and would be what I called twitchy. But that was pretty much it. And you know, a day or two after that, I would feel fine. So that was kind of the story for the 5 years after the first year that it started. So October of 2008, then 2009, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So 6 years, where it was really just an occasional thing. That wasn't a problem. I mean, in the whole scheme of things, it didn't really, it almost always happened at night. It kept me up all night, which was why I was miserable the next day. Sometimes it would last a couple days, but overall, it did not really impact daily function. I might have to like take a couple days to recover, but it wasn't, by no means was it a daily thing or any kind of frequent occurrence at that point. So that was for the, you know, 6 years after that. Sorry. So that's kind of the first half of the story, I guess. And then it wasn't until 2 winters ago, fall of 2014, that things got crazy. So I'm gonna stop this here, make that kind of part one of the story, and then I'll continue with part two.